Now for an important discussion as you study review engagements for your CPA exam, the forms of conclusions. Notice how I said conclusions. This is not an opinion. Remember, this is a review engagement, not an audit. An unmodified conclusion is expressed in the report when the account has obtained limited assurance. Here is an example of the wording you will find in the report when there is an unmodified conclusion. Based on our review, we are not aware of any material modifications that should be made to the accompanying financial statements for them to be in accordance with the applicable financial reporting framework, such as GAAP. If the accountant determines that the financial statements are materially misstated, a modified conclusion is expressed. In this situation, the accountant should use the heading qualified conclusion or adverse conclusion as appropriate for the conclusion paragraph in the accountant's new report. The accountant should also describe the matter causing modification under the heading basis for qualified conclusion or basis for adverse conclusion as appropriate in a separate section immediately before the conclusion. Okay, about now is when you're probably asking, okay, so when is the modified conclusion qualified and when is it adverse? Let's review, get it? Review, it's a review procedure. Okay, let's review so that you understand this modified conclusion. A qualified conclusion is appropriate when the effects of the matter causing the modification are material but not pervasive to the financial statements. The following language is used. Based on our review, except for the effects of the matter or matters described in the basis for qualified conclusion paragraph, we are not aware of any material modifications that should be made to the accompanying financial statements in order for them to be in accordance with the applicable financial reporting framework. Again, such as GAAP. An adverse conclusion is appropriate when the effects of the matter causing modification are both material and pervasive to the financial statements. Now, here's the language used in this example. We're talking about an adverse conclusion. Based on our review, due to the significance of the matter or matters described in the basis for adverse conclusion paragraph, the financial statements are not in accordance with the applicable financial reporting framework, such as GAAP. The basis for modified conclusion paragraph should describe and quantify the financial effects of the misstatement if the material misstatement relates to specific amounts in the financial statements, including quantitative disclosures. Explain how disclosures are misstated if the material misstatement relates to narrative disclosures. And describe the nature of omitted information if the material misstatement relates to the non-disclosure of information required to be disclosed. The accountant should include the omitted disclosures when practical to do so. A list of the basic elements of a review report is our next topic. We will discuss each element of the report in the order that it's presented. The title is Independent Accountant's Review Report. Now, this title highlights the accountant's independence and clearly identifies the nature of the engagement as a review to distinguish it from other services provided on the financial statements, most notably an audit. The report should be addressed as required by the circumstances of the engagement, for example, to a company's owner. Now, the introductory paragraph doesn't have a heading, but states that a review has been conducted, provides the name of the entity, specific information about the statements on which the accountant is reporting, and the date or period covered by each statement. It states that a review primarily includes applying analytical procedures to management's financial data and making inquiries of company management. It clarifies that a review is less in scope than an audit, and that an opinion is not being expressed on the financial statements, and as it would be if it was the case if it was an audit. The management's responsibility for the financial statements section states that management is responsible for the preparation and fair presentation of the statements in accordance with the applicable financial reporting framework. This responsibility includes designing, implementing, and maintaining internal control relevant to the preparation and fair presentation of financial statements that are free from material misstatement, whether due to fraud or error. The accountant's responsibility section states the accountant's responsibility is to conduct the review in accordance with SARS. States the accountant's belief that the evidence obtained provides a reasonable basis for the conclusion, and the accountant is required to be independent and meet other ethical responsibilities. The final section is headed Accountant's Conclusion and states the accountant's conclusion and identifies the country of origin of those accounting principles, if applicable. If the conclusion is modified, a basis for conclusion paragraph describing the cause of the modification is also included here. Now, the report is signed by the accountant or the accountant's firm. The city and state where the accountant practices are also identified. The report ends with the date of the review report. It should be dated no earlier than the date on which the accountant has obtained sufficient appropriate review evidence to support the conclusion. The accountant should consider including an alert on each page of the financial statements, referring readers to the independent accountant's review report. Now, this is intended to ensure that users understand that the financial statements are not audited. Recall that no reference to the audit is presented on each page of an audited financial statements, which is why the risk of misunderstanding the level of services provided could arise. The clear differentiation of reviewed from audited statements is significant due to the limited assurance provided in a review.